Web forms are a powerful tool for making forms such as contact forms, surveys, order forms, etc. that are highly customizable. In this tutorial, we'll walk through all the aspects of creating a web form. To start, go to Content Management, Create Content, and select Web Form. Give the form a title. Enter any content you want to appear above the form fields in the body field. This is optional and not required. You also have an optional sidebar box for publications and materials. If nothing is in these fields, they won't show. If linking to publications on the extension store, make sure you link correctly and do not download the publications. To view the video about how to link to extension store publications correctly, find the link and unlink video tutorial for the content editor. The How Extension Helps sidebar box is used to promote how ISU Extension and Outreach is impacting Iowa. Again, if you don't enter anything into this box, it will not show. To add a title to the box, highlight the text and select Heading 6 from the drop-down menu. Once you're done adding information to this edit form, click Save. You will be redirected to the Web Form tab, where you can add form components. You can begin by adding labels and selecting the type of field. We'll just add a basic Contact Us form as a test. So I've set the label to first and last name, and I'm going to go ahead and leave the type as text field, and I'm going to make this field required by selecting mandatory. You can add some of the information in if you want a default value. Most of the time, you're going to leave everything as the default, but if you have a field that you think doesn't make a bunch of sense or you want to include more instructions, you can add that in this description box. So I'm going to go ahead and save the component. We're going to add a phone number field, and again, I'm just going to leave it as a text field, but I'm not going to make it mandatory, just to show off the description. I'm going to enter a little help text in here. And click Save. Then I'm going to ask for their email address, and instead of using the text field type, I'm going to change it to email. This type verifies that it's an actual email address and that they haven't typed in something else. Again, I'm going to leave everything the same and hit Save. Then I'm going to ask them for a message, and I'm going to use the text area option. The text area option is just multiple rows of text, while the text field is just one single row. You can see there's lots of different options here: a date format, field set, file, grid, hidden, markup, number, page break, select options, and time, in addition to the field and text area. You can play around with those and find out which is going to work best for your needs, but they're fairly self-explanatory. Okay, so now that we have some form components, we're just going to go look at the form real quick so you can see what it looks like now that we've entered it. So you can see I've got my help text underneath the phone number field. Oh, it doesn't look like I selected the right thing for message. Oh, I selected email for message. So we're going to go back, delete that real quick. And select the correct one. As you notice, there's no way to change it after you've saved the field, so you do have to go in and delete. So let's view that again. There you go. There's the text area, so you can see a noticeable difference in how much information they're allowed to add. So once I'm happy with the way my form looks, it got all of the form components added, I'm going to go up to this little emails button right underneath the web form tab. And this is where I'm going to add who I want to get an email when this form is submitted. So I'm just going to put in a hopefully fake email right now and click add. And I can change the email to address. So that's what I just added, and I'm happy with that. I can change the email subject. So what's the subject of the email going to be when I get it? Do I want it to be the default? Do I want a custom subject line? Do I want one of the form components to be the subject line? I can choose all of that. I have the same options for the email from address. I can choose the actual user's email address for the from address. And the email from name. And again, I've asked for their first and last name, so I'm going to use that as the component. And then you see the email template here. This is a generic template. You can change what's included. If I don't want to see their phone number, I can just unclick that button and it won't email it to me. Then I'll hit save email settings when I'm done. Then we have the form settings page where I can add a confirmation message to let people know that I did get the web form once it was submitted. I can set the submission limit, how many submissions are allowed for this web form total. So say I only want 50 feedbacks ever from this web form, I would set the limit to 50. I can set a per user submission limit, so I'm only going to let each person use the contact us form 3 times. And I can even select the roles that are allowed to submit the form, but I recommend leaving that as a default setting. And I can change a few different other options here. I can choose what the submit button text says, so I'm going to change it to go. We'll just view that again. And there you go. You can see that it's changed. Now, as you can see, the web form is currently unpublished. That's by default. Every time you add a web form, it is unpublished. So once you're done editing it and it's set up the way that you want, you'll go back to the edit screen and select publishing options on the right-hand side and make sure published is checked so that it actually is published for people to see. You can also set up scheduling options here as well, publish on and unpublish on dates using the format in this handy green help box that comes up. Unpublishing a web form is just making sure that publish box is unchecked, and deleting a web form, you can just click the delete button here. Just remember that deleting a web form removes it entirely from your website and there's no way to get it back. So just make sure that you definitely never need this web form again if you're going to delete it. Obviously, this is a testing web form and I don't want to save it on this particular site. So I'm going to go ahead and delete it permanently.